Thank you, Brother Tim. Prayers are really valuable to the saints. So I arranged my papers here. The first thing I want to say is that at last year's renewal, I requested the brethren pray for me concerning a physical problem I was having. And I want to thank Brother Al Stoner for the very wise advice that he gave me. God gave me grace to find out that there were certain foods that was causing my trouble. And I praise God that I'm feeling better now than I have in several years. So I thank you all for your prayers. It's been a couple of months ago, a conversation I had on telephone with a very dear sister of mine, sister in the Lord. And we were talking about our testimonies. She made a comment, and it's exactly how I felt at the time. And she said, "I know we're accepted, but I don't want to say anything stupid." And well, I'm going to spare her embarrassment and not tell you who that is, because she said if I said who it was, she would deny it. So I won't tell you who it was, but I will tell you this. She will be speaking with her testimony at 2:15 tomorrow. Now, with that said, I suppose that I could start out by telling about my history of living in darkness, sinning against God, but that would profit nothing. I do want to tell you that my background is very, very dark, and it's in the background. I've come to the conclusion that after years of living in darkness, filling the mind with garbage, that it can become a mass of putrid slime that is totally offensive to God. I know that sounds sickening, but I want to express how devastating sin can be. I recall Brother Jeremy's testimony at the St. James Renewal about fitting in. I suppose that's everyone's wish, to be accepted by others. That has always been my desire. When one group would not accept me, then I would turn to another group. I learned that there is always certain ways, however, that I did not fit in, and I was never totally accepted. Now I know that it's not necessary to be accepted by the world. The goal is to be accepted by God. And when I believed the gospel that God sent his son, I indeed was accepted by him, as well as all those who have a like precious faith. I want to thank you, Brother Jeremy, for that testimony 6 years ago. It will always remain with me, and it will always serve as a reminder of where I truly fit in. Now, in sharing this testimony with you, my intention is to praise God by telling you how he has directed my path. I'm going to name people by name, and I know I'm going to leave out some names, but everyone here and everyone at the Word of Truth Fellowship is included. I've used and I've heard people, many people, use all kinds of reasons or excuses why they reject the things of God. At the time, it seems justified in the mind. All it amounts to is an unwillingness to give up that which is more appealing. The truth cannot be seen because it's being hidden, and it's being hidden because of sin. With God, there is no excuse for sin. It's written this way in Romans chapter 1, verses 18 through 20. The wrath of God is being revealed from heaven against all of the godlessness and wickedness of men who suppress the truth by their wickedness. Since what may be known about God is plain to them, because God has made it plain to them. For since the creation of the world, God's invisible qualities, His eternal power and divine nature have been clearly seen, being understood from what has been made, so that men are without excuse. That's from the NIV. I remember what my brother Bill told me once during a situation that I'd gotten myself into. He said this, he said, you have to decide one way or another. Now, I made that decision, and I'm still married to her. Sister Sue and I were married on February 19th. What year, huh? 1984? Which, I didn't write that down. Which is her birthday, and it's also the day that she was baptized into the Lord. Now, I know there's at least one exciting event on that day for her. Now, even though I put on a face of righteousness at times, I was still away from God, and I was most miserable. The Lord worked through my wife, He worked through my brother, and in time He softened my heart. I became more sensitive towards the things of God. The words my brother said to me about making a decision one way or another stuck in my mind. So I applied it to another decision I had to make. You see, we only have two choices. Choosing God and what He offers to those who believe, or choosing the way of the devil and the consequences that follow. One leads to life, the other leads to death. My problem was that I had fallen away. I wanted to get back in the race. So I became active in the church, and I was seeking to be closer to God and to God's people. But I was being hindered because I was lugging around a burden of guilt. It was difficult for me to believe that God would forgive me after all the evil I had done, which is a sign of immaturity. But also, there were some things that I was reluctant to give up. And as I look back on it, that was probably my largest hindrance. I must add also that the church I was attending at the time did not make the priority to be the edification of the saints. The focus, for the most part, was on building projects and how to get more people in the door. I discovered that being active in the church could also be a hindrance in advancement to the faith. I'm sure a lot of you know what I'm talking about. Then came the day my brother told me he was planning a prayer meeting at the Gasconade River Campground. And a man named Given Blakely would be preaching on the prayers of a righteous man. It's going to be hard for me not to cry at certain points in this, because these things are very dear to my heart. Given spoke with power. He also spoke with wisdom, and I knew that this could only come from God. I had never heard preaching in this manner, and I wanted to hear more. He gave us his personal testimony also, and I knew that he had great faith. I'm not boasting in a man as much as I am boasting in the Lord for the way he was speaking through Brother Given. Sometimes it doesn't take a lot of words to get someone to start thinking about something, especially when the heart is willing. Like when Brother Bill told me I needed to decide between one or another, it was like that with Brother Given when I was able to talk to him one-on-one after the meeting. He said to me, Brother Dave, because you are struggling, give evidence that you are saved. I want to tell you this too, that being called brother really sounded good to me. There was a lot more spoken between us than that, but those are the few words that got me to thinking about certain things, and also I started to researching scripture more. Romans chapter 7 became more clear to me. I was able to come to the conclusion that those who are not saved do not have this war going on in their minds. Why would they? Their hearts are set on the things of this world, and they are only interested in satisfying the flesh. There is no struggle because they have not been born again. When the new man is put on, it requires the casting off of the old man. Ephesians 4:20 says it this way, that ye put off concerning the former conversation the old man, which is corrupt according to the deceitful lusts. You see, guilt is associated with the old man, and the old man is the body of sin. It's written in Romans 6, verse 6, knowing this, that our old man is crucified with him, that the body of sin might be destroyed, that henceforth we should not serve sin. I started receiving the banner of truth, the word of truth. Now, through the banner of truth, I was introduced to other men like Al Stoner Jr., Dave Maddock, Fred Blakely, and Dean Bolt, and others. It was like the Bible had just been introduced to me. I started seeing things in Scripture that I had never seen before. Then again, on another day, Brother Bill was telling me that he had been asked to speak to Refreshing Waters Renewal in Indiana. Well, I remember thinking I wasn't going all the way to there for that. You see, I had it in my mind it was like a revival, and I was not fully persuaded to use my time off and go that far for that. Well, the Lord knew that I should be persuaded. So the following year, he brought the renewal to St. James, Missouri, which was only an hour or so from my home. I must admit, now let me back up a minute too. During that year, the Lord worked with me in a lot of ways and convinced me that that is where I need to go too. Regardless of how far it was, I probably would have went anyway. So I have to admit, at that first renewal, I was very intimidated because it wasn't like going to church. You see, before I could listen to a sermon, and then afterwards I could go talk with others about sports, kids, jobs, gardens, and so on. Now, at the renewal, most of the talk was about what was just preached on. And I got to be honest with you, I didn't know how to do that. I know that I might have appeared to some of you that I was maybe a strange person when I walked up to your conversation and I just stood there like a dummy. Well, there's a good reason for that. I was a dummy. But I was listening. I was interested in what was being said and I wanted to learn more. By the time my first renewal had ended, Sister Sue and I both decided that we would do whatever it takes to not miss another one. I made sure that I always had enough vacation days on the books. I also scheduled that week off at least 6 months in advance so no one would beat me to it. Let me add, too, that I now see that the Lord was causing me to be jealous. See, I wanted what the other brethren had. Isn't that the way God worked with the Jews in order to save some of them? Romans chapter 11. And I need to add something else here, too. Going to church has not been the same since, and I'm glad for it. Amen. Then again, Brother Bill mentioned to me that I might want to visit Joplin and attend the Friday night meetings at Brother Given and Sister June's house. Now, do you see a pattern here? Well, that started a whole new chapter in my life. By this time, Brother Ricky Sims and his family had been directed by the Lord to move to Joplin. Also, Brother Jeremy Williams and his family. I met Brother Ricky Sims for the first time in the parking lot at the hotel in St. James, and at that time, I had no idea how the Lord would use him to teach me many things concerning the kingdom of God, as well as all of the others at the Word of Truth Fellowship. And also, it's amazing how Sister Sue and I have come to have such a close fellowship with them. Now, I was so excited by the things that I heard at the renewals, also at the Word of Truth, that I wanted to share it with others. especially the church we were attending. To my disappointment, I learned that not everyone was as interested as I was. I was a teacher of the adult Sunday school class for some time, but I quickly learned that if I strayed from the standard lesson too far, I met with opposition, and also if I messed with traditions, then I made enemies. Let me say also that using the standard commentary lessons did not challenge the mind, and it was quite easy to prepare. When I started using the lesson book as a guide and got deeper in the Word and shared the things I was learning from the tapes and articles and my visits to Joplin, then I got into trouble. It wasn't my goal to cause trouble. I wanted others in the church to be strengthened as I had been. I have been edified by the brethren at the Word of the Truth, fellowship, and at the renewals. And I wanted to edify others. I'm sorry that did not happen. Sister Sue and I try to get back to Joplin and meet with the brethren there as often as we can. It's the only place we have found in our area where we know that we are loved. They actually tell us that we are a blessing to them. And that was strange to hear for the first time. But understand it now. I was thinking, excuse me, I can't see through my glasses. I was thinking about what made the difference between the Word of Truth Fellowship and that of the churches we had been attending. It occurred to me that what is being experienced at the Word of Truth is a true desire to know God, to love God more, love and edification of the brethren, and joy in the Spirit. I see that at the renewals too. The focus is on the unseen and not on the things that are seen. As I look back at the reasons I advanced to the place I am now, I can see that it had a whole lot to do with desire. I desired, and I still desire, to know more about God and the gospel that He gave through His Son. When God sees a true desire, He will respond. There's a proverb that says, "Hope deferred maketh the heart sick, but when the desire cometh, it is a tree of life." Again, it's written in 1 Peter 2:2. "As newborn babes, desire the sincere milk of the Word, that ye may grow thereby." Jesus promised us this, Matthew 5:6, "Blessed are they which do hunger and thirst after righteousness, for they shall be filled." The teachings that I was used to was not fulfilling, and it left me empty, with no desire to hear more of that type of preaching and teaching. After hearing preaching from Brother Given and listening to Brother Bill with a more godly attitude, I was hungry for the Word. I remember praying and asking God to help me understand, and if understanding was not directly given to me, then I asked Him to lead me to someone who could teach me. Now I've been overwhelmed by the number of brethren the Lord has introduced me to. The Lord has seen the desires of my heart, and He responded. One of the first things the Lord showed me was about believing. See, I was using the word believe like the world uses it, not the Spirit. I had heard comments from several brethren, comments like, "What part of believe don't you understand?" They wasn't commenting to me. I need to add that. Or, "Well, is there's something they aren't believing, or they wouldn't do that." Through the teaching of Brother Given, Brother Bill, and others, the Lord showed me that to believe in Him, I must be committed to Him. Faith became more defined in my heart. The Scripture speaks of faith as being the substance of things hoped for. Substance speaks to confidence. while listening to one of the Renewal tapes, I heard Brother Jason say that believing the gospel is what gives us our confidence. And Brother Aaron said that Jesus is our confidence. Also, because of what Sister June said, I learned that my confidence is in Jesus because he has done everything for me. Remember in Acts 14:2, it says, "But the unbelieving Jews stirred up the Gentiles and made their minds evil affected against the brethren." That tells me that disobedience is unbelieving. So needless to say, John 3:16 took on a whole new meaning to me. Paul told the Corinthians, 1 Corinthians 3:5, "Who then is Paul, and who is Apollos, but ministers by whom ye believed, even as the Lord gave to every man." Paul and Apollos were servants through whom the Corinthians believed. Brother Bill, Brother Given, and all the brethren I have met at the Renewals and those at the Word of Truth Fellowship in Joplin are servants through whom I have come to believe. When I was very young, the seed was planted by Brother Roy Weiss, and I praise God for leading me to all the brethren who has watered with an abundance. I wish that I could have met Brother Fred Blakely, spent more time with Brother Dean Bolt, tell them what a benefit they were to me, and still are. That will have to wait for now, but it won't be long till there'll be no more going out. Amen. The Lord has enabled us to be at every Renewal since the first one at St. James, Missouri. I never thought that I would stand and speak to the very brethren who has encouraged us so much over the last 6 years. I'm very honored and humbled to be able to tell you that my faith has increased because of your ministry. Your work has not been in vain, and I thank you through our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who desires that none should be lost. I'll leave you with this verse, Isaiah 11:10. "And in that day there shall be a root of Jesse, which shall stand for an ensign," or an ensign of the people. "To it shall the Gentiles seek, and his rest shall be glorious." It's a wonderful prophecy, and we are blessed to be living in the days of its fulfillment. Christ has been raised up, and he is seated at the right hand of God. The only way to know God is to look to the one who has been raised up. Jesus stands for an ensign of the people, as those of Israel. Jesus is the standard. Amen.